Welcome everyone. So our today's topic is life processes in living organisms. So student, we have already completed the two videos from this lesson, part 1 and part 2, and this is part 3 video of this lesson. Okay, so you can observe the some structure or some organ system on the screen, like kidneys are there, vein, arteries, and like a pouch like a urinary bladder is there. Okay, so this is related to excretory system, and our today's topic is about excretion in human beings. Okay, for class 9. So let's study the video. Alright, so what is excretion? So student, we know that in our body there are various process, living process are happening step by step, like digestion is there, respiration is there, okay, and throughout this process many chemical substances and many chemical reaction are taking place, and due to this the waste material, like many harmful and waste substances like urea, uric acid, ammonia, etc. are produced in living organism. And if these substances accumulate in the body or are retained in the body for a long, it can lead to serious harm or even death. So these harmful material are very they can cause very serious effect on our health. All right, and hence it is necessary to remove such harmful and waste substances from the body, and different organism have different method to of doing this. So removal of waste or harmful substances from the body of an organism is called excretion. Okay, so I hope you all have understood the excretion. All right, so in unicellular organism, waste material are directly eliminated throughout the single cell. Unicellular, that means they have only one cell, so the waste material easily get out from there body or the cell. Okay, but the process of excretion in multicellular organism is little complex. So in our previous video we have covered the excretion in plants. Okay, you can check the description box for the link of that video. Now let's study the excretion in humans. All right, so student, there are different organ system in the human body to bring about a different life process, such as the digestive system for digestion, okay, and respiratory system for respiration, like lungs, trachea, and all. And this is a circulatory system for the circulation of a blood throughout the body. You can observe the heart. Okay, so heart will pump the blood, and oxygenated, deoxygenated blood, it will filtration of the blood, and the filtered blood will supply to the whole body. Okay, and the process of digestion leading to energy production is an important process of our body. That means in the digestion of digestive process, the energy production takes place, and it produce many of the harmful substances in our body. And for removal of these waste from the body is very important, and it is the excretory system that carried out that function. Okay, so you can observe the pair of a kidney, urinary bladder, urethra, artery, and vein. So let's study the detail about the excretory system for excretion. All right, so this is a proper excretory organs for the excretory system. Like you can observe here the kidneys, up to kidneys like left kidney, right kidney, ureter, urinary bladder, and urethra, like renal vein, renal artery. So these are all are included in the excretory system of the human being. Okay, so the human excretory system consists of a pair of a kidneys, a pair of a ureters, like two ureters, and the urinary bladder and urethra. All right, so these are the ureter and urinary bladder and urethra. So these are the pair of a kidneys, and urine is formed by the kidneys by separating the waste and unwanted excess substances from the blood. Like the heart is pumping the blood to the body. Okay, likewise kidney also, it formed the urine by the filtration of the blood. In our blood there are many waste materials are there, so function of the kidney is to filter the blood and just form the urine. All right, so the two bean shaped kidneys are situated one on either side of the vertebral column. on the posterior side of the abdomen, that means at the back side of the abdomen, and backbone, the kidneys are present. Okay, and the functional unit of the kidney that perform the basic function of filtration is called the nephron. That means nephron perform the basic function of the filtration. All right, so this is a proper structure. You can observe the downside of kidney and then kidney to nephron. So this is a structure of a nephron in which the basic filtration has been done. And each kidney, each nephron has a cup-like thin walled upper part called as a Bowman's capsule. So you can observe here a Bowman's capsule. This is just a cup-like and thin walled part of the nephron. And the network of a capillaries in it is called as a glomerulus. So this is a glomerulus which you can observe inside the Bowman's capsule. Alright, and the urea produced in the liver comes into the blood. When the urea containing blood comes into the glomerulus, it is filtered through its capillaries, and urea and other similar substances are separated from it. It means that blood which contains the urea, it will go into the glomerulus, and there the proper filtration has been done, and the urea, blood which carries the urea and the useful substance, so these two are separated into the glomerulus. And water molecules and small molecules of some other substances can cross the semi-permeable membrane of a Bowman's capsule. That means it will those water molecule will easily pass out from the semi-permeable membrane of the Bowman's capsule. Okay, so this is a tubular network of the nephron. So the solution accumulated in the cavity of Bowman's capsule passes into the tubular part of the nephron, and here the molecules of water and some other useful substances are again reabsorbed into the blood. Alright, so urine is formed from the remaining solution which is full of waste material. That means urine which contains the urea, it is just full of waste material and it will be secreted out from the body. Okay, and the urine is carried by the ureters and is stored in the urinary bladder. So you can observe here the urinary bladder. So after the filtration of the blood taken place into the kidney, the urine which is produced in the kidney has been come into the urinary bladder by the pipe like structure, ureter. Okay, so this is a pouch like structure, urinary bladder, in which the urine is stored. Okay, so afterward urine is given out through the urethra. And the urinary bladder is muscular, that means the urinary bladder is made up of muscles and it is under the control of nerves. And hence we are able to keep a control on urination. Though the kidneys are main organs of excretion in human being, the skin and lungs also help in the process of excretion. Alright, so here you can observe the right kidney is a slightly lower position than the left kidney. Okay, and each kidney, and why this is so? Because the presence of a liver above the right kidney. So the right kidney is found much lower than the left kidney because it has to accommodate the liver, the largest gland in the human body. So liver is the largest gland of the human body, which is just present just above the right kidney. That's why the position of the right kidney is lower than the left kidney. And each kidney has approximately 10 lakh nephron, and approximately 5 liter of blood which is present in the normal healthy person's blood is filtered by the kidneys about 400 times every day. And thus every day the kidneys filter about 190 liters of blood, from which about 1 to 1.9 liters of urine is formed, and the remaining liquid which is useful is reabsorbed into the blood. So this was all about the human excretory system, which is little complicated, and I hope you all have understood. Alright, now let's understand what is dialysis. So this is alongside, you can observe the dialysis machine. Alright, so dialysis of blood. Let's see what it is. Okay, so the efficiency of kidneys can be adversely affected by injury, infection, and decreased blood supply. In case this happens, an excess of toxic substances accumulates in the body and it can led to the death. So the main function of the kidney is just filter the blood and produce the urine. But what happened is if our kidney is injured, so due to the injured kidney, the waste material like nitrogenous waste are just there in our blood, and which can cause the death of the person also. Okay, and if kidney fail, nitrogenous waste are separated from the blood with the help of a man-made machine, and the process of separating the nitrogenous waste from the blood with the help of this machine is called dialysis. So if the kidney has been injured, so by using the dialysis machine, the nitrogenous waste materials have been separated from the blood with the help of a machine. Okay, and about 500 ml of blood is sent at one time through this machine, and purified blood is re-infused into the body of the patient. So this is a dialysis of a blood, and here the process has been given, like you can observe here the vein, artery, shunt, okay, and the blood pump. So this is all the mechanical process by which the filtration of the blood or the nitrogenous waste material separating from the blood of the body. All right, so student, this is all about this video, and I hope you all have understood very well the excretory system of in the human being. And next part of the video we can continue in our next session. Okay, so here you can observe the blood is get into the kidney, and after filtration of the blood, the urine is produced and it has been transferred to the urinary bladder. Thank you.